Woo!
Man, having a white knuckle experience over here pulling this Wagoneer. I got something all balanced, so I'm about to pull over and try to fix it. So we are actually back down in Perry where we bought the Wagoneer Penny. So what we didn't tell you is that same day we came down here and bought Penny the Wagoneer, we actually made a deal for another Wagoneer. So we bought two for the price, what I'll say the price of one. So we're actually headed back down here to pick it up now. We're on the guy's road that owns it. So we're gonna be picking it up, dragging it back to Marietta. They kind of figuring out what to do from there, but we'll show it to you as soon as we get here. Thanks for coming along on the ride.
So we just pulled up and the Wagoneer's out there, but there goes a little deer running across the field. You can see the Wagoneer all the way out there. I'm gonna go in here and talk to this fella.
So this is it. It's another 86 Wagoneer like the other one that we bought for Sarah, and it's actually pretty well like Sarah's was originally. So it's a darker color with the wood grain down the side. This one's in pretty good shape. I haven't really looked it over, but we went package price on this one and the other one. Doesn't like the drip rails are bad. It's definitely had a repaint. I think it was that lighter color silver, and I know it's super bright out here and hard to see, but bought right here. Well, we're actually in Perry. It was bought at AMC Jeep and Warner Brothers, or AMC Jeep, Warner Robins, right here in Georgia. So that's pretty cool. Missing some hubcaps. Ain't no telling what it looks like underneath. Definitely a little more roached on the interior, but for the price, couldn't beat it. So we're gonna take this thing, get it loaded up on the trailer. It's all here, we know that, so that's good. What it it's got a 360 under the hood like most of them this year. It's got the Select Track four-wheel drive. It's got some wiring issues. Let me look under here, make sure I'm not about to get stung. So it's definitely got some wiring issues, but it's all here. Guy said it ran, except something's going on right here with all this wiring. So we're gonna get it loaded up, take it back to the shop, see if Mike and I can't sort out the wiring, and go from there.
This looks.
Wow. It's a little more rusty under here. You can tell it's been sitting. But this sucker's worth messing with. Okay, all loaded up. It's a little dirtier on the frame, maybe a little more surface rust because this one's been sitting up for a while, but actually looks good down through the front part of the frame. We're excited about it. Clean title, just like the other one. We're gonna take and make something cool. As far as body damage, that's about to really the only thing I can see right now. Who knows, but it's a good one for
for messing with. You ready to get out of here?
We're ready, are you?
Where's Mill?
Did you bring a change of shirt?
Hey, Mill. This is actually the same spot we showed y'all the other Wagoneer. Man, I'm pleased with this. I am so pleased. Just hard to beat. Full wood grain Wagoneer. Needs a lot of work. But it'll run and drive as soon as we get those wiring issues sorted. We got another Wagoneer. I really don't know how else to say it. I think I've been bitten by the bug, like many are bitten by the C10 bug, and we bought another Wagoneer. Sort of. Let me tell you about it. So, story is, we find the 86 Wagoneer that we now call Penny online, and we go to look at it and purchase it for my wife. So, we get down there, start checking it out, and I notice there's another Wagoneer sitting over by the guy's barn, off on the backside of a pasture. Naturally, I'm interested, and I say, what's the deal with that one? He said, the guy came by here and offered me this much, and well, I wouldn't take that, but I'll take this for it. And I immediately got my wheels turning and thought, I like this other one that we now call Penny. Maybe I can make a package deal on both. Why don't we walk out here, take a look at the other Wagoneer you got set back here in the pasture. So we go check it out. I think it's solid enough. It's definitely a builder, as you're seeing in this video. It's all there, all original. Once again, I thought, man, I think I just need to go ahead and try to make a package deal on this. I can get to work on Penny, make sure that's right for my wife and my family, and then I can tuck this one away until we're ready to start working on it, which is exactly what I'm doing. I'm taking it up to our indoor storage. Tuck it away for a little while, or covered storage, I should say, not indoor storage. It's covered on three sides. Taking the Wagoneer up there now, but woo! Man, having a white knuckle experience over here pulling this Wagoneer. I got something off balance, so I'm about to pull over and try to fix it. Okay, so I'm definitely having some serious sway issues going down the road with the Wagoneer on the trailer. Probably because I got it loaded on backwards, which I never advise doing, but the way I had to load this thing up, that's what I had to do. So what I'm gonna do is essentially use the winch and just pull it forward. I think that'll take some of the weight off of the rear of the trailer and stop the swaying. Never in my life have I had any sort of... Let me try it again. Okay, let's try that again. Never in my life have I had any sort of swaying issue where the trailer gets to doing this at all, ever. In all the times, years that I've hauled a bunch of trucks. But this one scared me twice on the way up. Okay, got that done. So, what I was saying, never had a truck get to swaying on a trailer like I have this one. So, definitely thinking we're just really, really far off. Probably need to go take it out of park. Let's see if I can even get it out of park. There it goes. So now we're in neutral. I guess I should act like I've done this before, huh? I think that's gonna do it right there. I gotta say, I do not like not having control over the trailer and over the vehicle on it. So give me just a second and I'll tell you what we're gonna do to remedy some of it. The crow is just yapping. So I'm feeling like it's in a lot better position. Like I said, I typically don't like to even load them backward, but get the weight of the motor, but there's a lot of extra sheet metal, a lot of glass back here. So I've learned that that can help balance you out. However, I did not have it balanced well enough at all. It's a new tow rig. I haven't really talked that much about it. Just really, because I hadn't wanted to. It's the new 2020 Crew Cab 3.0 Duramax. But really the thing I want to point you to is this massive amount of squat. And on the 2018 that I had, I did not have this much squat and I did not have this much bounce in the rear end. So what we're going to do is put a load lifter situation in here, the airlift, load lift bags, I think they're 5,000 pound bags. Put those on the axle, completely bolt on. And then I've got this Gen Y hitch, but Gen Y actually, so this is their Mega Duty 16K. They make a 10K, 16K, 21K. 21K, I believe it is, in their torsion flex, which basically means that they've designed a hitch that bolts in just like this, but it has some give in it. Like it has some little rubber bands that actually allows it to flex. So when the trailer's got a lot of movement, it's removing a lot of that from the actually transferring into the truck. So I'm gonna upgrade to that hitch to try to get a little bit of separation from this pushing the truck around or vice versa. And if we have to, may end up getting some stabilization bars, some weight stabilization bars. But I wanna stick with a half ton. I love the half ton. I love the ride when unloaded. And I just really like a half ton truck. So the 3.0 Duramax really does the job from a pulling perspective. It gets 30 something miles to the gallon. You know, it's super quiet. It gets great gas mileage pulling. But with the addition of the Lear camper shell on the back and a couple other things, I've got some stuff in the bed that makes it really, really heavy. I think it's time to go airbags on the rear with the airlift load lifters and definitely upgrade to the torsion flex hitch and then go from there. I'm gonna continue on to storage. Hopefully we won't have any more sway issues. See you guys there. Okay guys, so I feel like I need to tell you some information that was bestowed upon me in a scenario where a trailer is swaying. So I watch this channel called Keep Your Daydream. It's about this family who travels around in a camper about 9 months out of the year. They're in an Airstream and I've got all sorts of information coming on that and why that applies to our life. But I've been watching their channel for a little while. Super entertaining, super informative, very, you know, family friendly. So I watch it with my little girl and Jackson a lot. I want to tell you what Mark, who is the father, basically runs that channel. He said, when your trailer gets to swaying, I'd never heard this before, when your trailer gets to swaying like that, where it's like rocking side to side and really starting to pull your, you know, beginning to pull the tail end of the truck around, you want to reach down and depress your trailer brake completely. So that's what I'm doing and what I did when the trailer got to swaying. I literally just watched an episode, I can't even remember which one it was, where he talked about depressing your trailer brake because they had just had that happen. So big thanks to Mark over at Keep Your Daydream for bestowing that kind of information on us. And I'm here to bestow it on y'all if you didn't know. I did not know, and I'm really glad to know it now. So that definitely saved me twice in a row. So it happened twice in about 3 minutes coming up the interstate. I'm on a lot of grades, there's a lot more crosswind. I don't have quite as much weight in the truck. Nothing had changed in the way the Wagoneer was positioned on the trailer, but the crosswind, grades, curbs, less weight in this truck, I think may have impacted it running and wanting to sway and be a little more out of control and just be a little off balance. guys know how we ended up with another Wagoneer on the trailer, aside from Penny. And this is it. So appreciate you guys tuning in. Oh, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please consider doing so. Definitely smash that thumbs up button if you like what you've seen, and leave a comment down below. Let us know what your favorite part is about a Jeep Grand Wagoneer. Appreciate you guys. Catch you next time right here on United by Trucks.
Cue the music.